What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video, and today we're gonna talk about promises versus async await. So this is not a video explaining how async await works. There are a ton of videos out there which explain and do a much better job than me, but today I'm gonna talk about why would you want to use async await in place of promises. So to get started, I have a very simple example. I'm requesting the Hacker News API to kind of get some data and post it. So there are two variations of it. One is with promise and one is with async await. So if you take a look at this function, which actually uses promises, the first thing that you would notice is it is indented and there are a lot of callbacks, one inside each other. And this is what we typically called as promise hell or callback hell. As you can see, this code isn't really readable, nor it is maintainable. There are a lot of closures introduced and there is a lot of scoping that you need to get that right. So the gist is, this is not really good practice. Mind you that this works without any problems, this works flawlessly, but when this increases or there is more complexity introduced in some of these calls, then it becomes very hard to keep track of variables. To kind of counter these problems, there was another construct introduced in JavaScript, which was called async await. So there are three constructs to handle asynchronous in JavaScript. One is promise, one is async await, and the other is callback. If you haven't seen my video on promises, I'll leave a link in the description as well as in the I button. You can go ahead and watch that. That's where I talk about promises and why I preferred promises over async await. But over a period of time, I've realized that async await is kind of something that I want to use more. Now let's take a look at a function which does the same thing, but by using async await. And when you look at this code, it becomes very easy to understand. So there is a variable res, which is basically the result of this function call. It is the same variable which is getting overridden by the value of this call and then by this call. And then you're finally logging the value here. So there are two things that you need to understand here. One, the function is marked async, and what you would see is there is no more nesting or indentation like you see here. So this kind of makes the code more readable. You know what happens after what, and it's much easier to maintain. So this is the main benefit of using async and await over promises. One more thing is, whenever you mark a function async, it returns a promise. So if you look at this function call, I can chain it with a then, because an async function would return a promise. So currently there is nothing which comes in res, because I haven't returned anything. But if I return anything from here, then I'll be able to catch the value here. Now let's take a look at what happens when I run this code. So once I run this, it will take some time, and yes, we have here the answer. So now if we scan the output, this is the console.log inside of my function which uses promises, and as you can see, all of this is async. So this will be pushed onto the event loop, and once these kind of resolve, the internal calls would run. So this prints before any of these calls return, so that's why you see this running first. And then this is basically the output that I print here. So this console.log, the value is here. That's after the done. But if you look at the way in which this async function actually works, it's kind of interesting. So first off, you see this console.log, which you see here. But then it doesn't actually print this directly. It actually prints it after you console.log the output of res, because the async function makes the code inside of your function synchronous. So that is kind of contradictory to the name, but yeah, that's what async function does. It makes the code inside of your function synchronous. So that's why you see the order in which it is defined here is the order in which it prints. And then the done kind of prints, because there is nothing else to process, so it would return, and it didn't fail anywhere, it didn't throw any error, so it resolves to a success, and you console.log done. So yeah, so that's a quick difference between promise and async await. I hope you might have found this video helpful. If you did, be sure to hit the like button and the subscribe button. I know I haven't been very regular in uploading videos, but from now I will try to. So yeah, be sure to subscribe. Also, I've started streaming on Twitch. I don't have a schedule figured out right now, but you can go ahead and give a follow there, and you'll get a notification every time I come live. So yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you guys are safe. Thank you guys for joining, and I'll see you guys in the next one.